Welcome. I gotta give y'all a name. I realized I have not gave my audience a Let's Talk Big Fella name. Mm-hmm. So I will have that in it. But welcome to y'all back. Welcome to y'all back to Let's Talk Big Fella. Recorded in historic St. Louis, Missouri. Go follow Always Forward Media on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, and TikTok. Rate us and review us from wherever you get your podcast from, and also rate us on YouTube, follow us and share. Give us 5 stars if you see us on the podcast on Apple and everywhere else. If you don't give us 4 stars, I must assume you are the ops, and for the ops, we have solutions. Let's Talk Big Fella is the place for the plus size mind and in-depth conversation that provoke the mindset of your favorite big fella. I am.
Come on. It's the podcast, Daddy.
Hello.
Sometimes.
But no one and nothing is necessarily perfect, right?
Absolutely not.
And we know this. So there's going to be some kind of something that you can argue about. And it's just going to make the sex better. Turn it up.
Uh-huh.
Turn it up.
Right.
Whoa. Turn it up.
Ah. Ooh. Mm.
About to pick an argument with you. Come on. It's the podcast, Daddy. I'm about to pick an argument with you.
Ah. Ah. Ooh. Ah.
Argument with you.
All right. All right. I am Marcus Onesimus Boston. Welcome.
Listeners.
And we have K-Mo is back. She's back again.
In full effect.
We're back.
Thank you for having me again.
Still black. Yeah. You know, I'm known to make bad decisions repeatedly.
Oh, wow.
I'm not saying you are one. Don't do that. Don't hit me with the wow.
I am a bad decision on your best day.
No. You didn't receive it the way it's supposed to be delivered. That's what it was.
No, you just an ass. Naturally.
No.
It's okay.
No.
You didn't hurt my feelings because I'm K-Mo from the M.O.
Wow. That's what we're going with?
Yeah, so let me blow your mind.
Ooh, man. Man, bless your heart.
Yes, always. I am blessed. Thank you for asking.
All right, well, guys, welcome back to Let's Talk Big Fella. I am your host, Marcus Onesimus Boston. Welcome to the mob. They also called me.
Come on. It's the podcast, Daddy.
Podcast Papi.
And one day, I'm on the road to really embracing like all the things I've created. Because I've created shit that sounds good. I'd be like, am I really not a superhero? I'm going to let them niggas die. But anyway. Hey, K-Man, welcome back.
You have to believe.
Yeah, I'm a reluctant everything.
I don't know why. But thank you for welcoming me back, because I am a conundrum.
Conundrum's an interesting choice. I would use something else that sound like that.
What is that?
Dun-dun-dun-dun. Sorry.
He gave me a theme.
I missed. All right. So, first we're going to start off with the week. How was your week?
Man. It was a week. I mean, it was a week. I mean, it ain't like.
Right. She's killing it.
I don't know.
It was a week. Days passed and hours turned into the. We know how the mechanics work. Could you tell us
I'm a mother, you know, so, man, there's a routine that you have to do throughout the week. I'm one of the fortunate ones.
And kids on spring break and shit. I was like,
man, you gotta find a child care provider, you know, for them.
Man.
You gotta like pay them to watch your kid, you know. I have pretty decent children. They're great. Anyone would want to babysit them. That's what I would say.
I mean, anyone is really, really high. I'm just saying because, like, anyone would include me, and, like, that is not what...
I mean, I wouldn't let you watch my children.
Yeah, like, don't leave me in charge. I mean,
you like, you don't, you know, you're a single bachelor, so...
I'm easily corruptible. I'm very impressionable, so, like, if your kids are smart... They convince
They're
me that
highly
this is a bad idea. This is a bad idea.
They only come from the best breed, okay?
I mean, breed sounds like we talking about some pack of horses. And I don't like the,
no, you know,
the
word I mean, breed. You know, I think that your lineage, you know, counts for something. So, you know, I have the resiliency in me. So I know that they have it in them.
I just think that, yeah, don't let me do it. Because I'll be like, you know, when you presented the argument, let's see what happens. No wonder if it fails, it's my fault. If it works out. These kids are brilliant, but I fall for it. So I'm like, don't leave me in charge of nothing you care about.
I mean, sometimes it's hard to be, you know, so accountable for so many people, you know.
Damn, I'm trying to do this shit. Keep talking, I'm sorry.
Relation to my job, you know, how the week went, you know. Just sometimes hard to be always accountable for other people's shit.
My week, thank you for sharing with us your week. I appreciate you.
You need to let me share, y'all.
I'll keep going. Keep going.
No.
No, I'm sorry. I thought you were trying to
get out
of it.
I would love to know more about your week.
Yeah, my week ain't
Mob.
No, my week was, you know, like, you know, people that, you know, a lot of forgiveness and understanding was given.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I didn't, you know, I was.
What you mean?
People came back that, you know, I didn't plan on getting back to.
But you rolled off.
I never, you know, I had, I was willing to do my time. Like, I wasn't going to file an appeal. I got my sentence, and I was going to do that time. But, you know, by the grace of God, they chose to give me early, you know, release on good behavior.
Mm.
And, you know, I'm going to take this time and learn from it and do better and see where it goes and let God lead the way.
Really? He found enlightenment, guys. That's the key word tonight. Enlightenment.
That was Marcus Boston X. That was Mob X. MOBX exclusive. But no, like, that was just, you know, you gotta. I have to live my raps. You know, so I say I have certain standards or, you know, whatever this thing is, sometimes you gotta believe it. And sometimes it means you gotta sit in that shit. It's like, if your kids get in trouble, you also in the house. You can't be like, well, you stay home, I'm going out. No, you have to stay home too, because that way he knows that, or she knows that the reason I'm on you, because I'm on me. You know what I'm saying? So you fuck up in school, we're gonna be in this motherfucking house miserable together, because I can be out doing some shit that I like to do some shit where you can be trusted and acting right as a child. Speaking of somebody that has no parents, but theoretically, that's how I feel. But everybody got to get punched in the mouth.
Well, I mean.
So I start fighting.
Did those things that came back to you make you feel good or happy, or, you know, like you resolved it, like you didn't want, you know, you got closure? Like,
I learned that the human experience is about having the experience. That's really what all I've come to accumulate from this. From, I like, you know, watching things and seeing people live, the good, the bad, the ugly, but all of it was chasing some kind of human experience of this happened to me. But the feeling of what this, that was, is what made me have this next feeling that made you have these feelings. Like, it's just experiences. So, like, you got to be interested, curious in the experience. So, my curiosity is at its highest level because it needs to be. And life is short. So, let me be curious and say, maybe I shouldn't, but let's see what happens. Like, I made enough decisions to be like, no, I ain't gonna do that because it's probably a bad idea. And I was like, it might be a bad idea, but let's see what comes out of it. Because I've seen other people that made bad decisions and came out of it better than the way they came out. But, well, maybe I can make good bad decisions that way. You know.
sure.
I'm too old to be out here making like certain decisions. Like, I'm too old for those. But like, there's somebody still like, okay, that's enough. Ooh, yeah, I feel it. I feel it's warm.
Mm-hmm. Right. Look at him laughing.
Ah, it's like, cut me, but don't leave a scar. Like, ah, I hurt. Okay.
He wants superficial wounds, guys. He's calling for superficial wounds.
Yeah, I don't want no shit though. I feel like I might be going home. Oh, kid. Oh, shit. I almost died. No, I didn't want to die. I just want like a cast. But I'm like, you're sighing. Like, ooh.
Yeah. Look. This is his life, guy.
Wow. Okay.
Big fella.
Woo!
Hey, fella.
So let's just get it back on the track. Because we got, that took a turn.
It didn't. He really wanted to express that, y'all. He was very excited about the people who reconnected in his life over the week.
Hey, because
he really thought they were final. They were final to you. You accepted them for what they were.
It was fine. I was going to sit in my consequences.
But it don't always have to be consequences. It's just really like...
Consequences ain't a bad
thing. Your experience.
Yeah, it's okay.
But you make it like, when you say consequences, like negatively, you know, it was like you automatically assumed you did something wrong.
That's just who I am. Like, I look to, something goes bad. I say, what did you do to contribute to this bad? First. So that way, I can be fine where I'm accountable for. So that way, when you attack me, I can say, you know what? You right. I'm like, nah, that wasn't me. Mm-mm. So, like, I look to blame self first, just so I'm prepared for you to blame me any fucking way. So that way, I can defend myself accordingly.
Mm.
So, that's just what it is. Like, if I'm gonna get the blame, make sure I did not come to work on time that day.
He has to find fault, you know, in the reasoning behind. Yeah, what,
like, I mean, if I'm gonna get my lashes, I'm gonna earn, these are mine lashes. They make my lashes, nah. They make mine. Give them, go over there. Like, I'm gonna take mine, but that motherfucker going over there. Like, Mark, I was my friend Mark podcast, thecunow.com, and one of the questions was, if you're on a raft of 30 people, you can only save 7. Out of this, because you're saving the 7 that's best to get you, that are best, like the best rowers to get you to safety.
To save you.
So you got to choose out of that 31, the 7 to stay. I said, Mark, there's no way everyone's going to die. Because if I say I'm choosing, like, how am I going to do this 7 without the people that finna die going to hear me choose this 7? And what if the 7, everybody that's 7 is going to lose somebody out of that 30? So I'm like, okay, well, out of that 7, they have to kill people as well.
Yeah.
They got to kill 3.2 people themselves, so that way, as the 7 survivors, we have all equal guilt.
No, I think that you're overanalyzing the situation. You know, sometimes people just want you to make a rational decision at the moment.
I see.
And they want to know that, like, is your thought, you know, is it like, without a doubt, without a reasonable doubt, would you choose me?
I see. I'm willing to let, if I'm going to be one of the 7 that lives, I can let the other 23 go.
Mm.
Now, well, like, next question. Okay, so I'm sorry.
That'd be hard because it weighs on the human consciousness.
I got to live with that, but I will live with that.
Nah.
Okay, well, I'm not trying to die.
Because some of your people you're going to choose are going to be people that, you know what I'm saying?
Everybody
you,
ain't always
you the fuck with, but they don't really mean that they the rowers or they the people that's going to save you or get you to safety.
Well, that the you question was... You know what I'm saying?
It's based purely upon emotion. So when somebody asks you those questions, it's really based purely upon emotion. How they emotionally feel about you.
I'm choosing my 7.
Well, you should always choose yourself.
And the rest of it is up to somebody else.
Outside of God. I'm gonna save my kids though.
Yeah, I don't. Yeah, that's why I was like, yeah, you asked the right person, because
those are like the fucking, those are the core of my being. They stripped away a part of me, and they've manifested it on their own.
I like that what you just said.
That's the core of like having children. You know what I'm saying? Like you want to manifest yourself times three. Mm. You get what I'm saying? Mm-mm. Imagine a little you times three. You get what I'm saying?
What woman meaning would allow that to happen?
They have your mindset, you know, and as as accomplishment as you may think you are not, you know, you are accomplished, you know, in some degree. But think of that times three. That's hard to think about.
He's going to be a villain. He's going to be like Lex Luthor. I want to win. Oh, no. I want my daddy's. What was you talking about? Anyway, moving forward. So, I want to check up on everybody in my shows for the week. So, The Mandalorian is going well. I really find me being attached to The Mandalorian because it's something about like it's something about like the character where you believe in this culture that you necessarily don't really understand, but you are a part of it. So as you buy into it, life makes you make a decision and you think that this culture is the end all be all because all you know. But then life throws you a curveball where you have to make a decision. Do I, you know, keep on the path that I know, or do I take this moment in time? I guess for me, the way I say it, for me in that show is like, I keep waiting for like this moment to happen. Like this movie moment where he just, do I continue being this bounty hunter or do I save this kid?
No, I mean,
the premise is
that it keeps you captivated on your seat, on the edge of your seat, because he's rogue and every decision is a snap judgmental decision. And it's based upon his morality and his fight of wanting to do what's right. You know, it's basically what's right to him. And so because he's so rogue, it's intriguing because he gets to make his own decisions. And I think in real life, you know, a lot of it is just like you have to work to be able to live, to be able to, you know. So a lot of things are not necessarily your actual decision. You don't get to make or decide like kind of what you do unless you do it in an entrepreneurial way. And in his regard, you know, he's outside. He's making it happen. You know, he is like, any decision that he make is based upon pure consciousness and morality based upon him. And so we are viewing it from the eyes of someone who is like looking at him like he's so rogue, you don't know what fucking decision he gonna make.
Camo, you almost convinced me you watched that show. You almost, I was finna get to all these details.
I mean, I have watched the show. I haven't caught up on the latest episodes because I am a mom, you know.
You are a mother. Your time is sparse.
Like, the weekend is my time. Shout out to my children's father. Who decides that the only available time is the weekend. So that's when I be like myself.
When I get my kids,
you better shut the fuck up. You got to make some kids to get some kids. Eligible bachelor, $1 million boat.
You're my angel.
Oh, angel.
You're my angel.
If I could, I'd give you the world.
Get some old girls going.
Wrap it all up.
Old things. Thank you. Needle on the head. Ooh, you know about this needle.
Won't be satisfied without this piece of my heart.
All right, back to my Mandalorian.
Okay.
So that's why that touches me in places I didn't plan on being touched by a Star Wars series.
Mm.
I watched the first two seasons again just to have a fresh understanding of what I'm watching.
Yeah, I look at all the time he has.
I did a really good job of making sure I had peace. I'll be at work.
Well,
When I be at work, they be like, is he at work yet? I'm on the way. We need you to, like, I'm not the only person that know how to do this here. I might be the best one, but I ain't the only one. Whatever. I was supposed to need the baker, but I got my glass on. I still can't see. Ah, here we go. Ah, buddy. So that is the Mandalorian time, Joy. Go. Oh, we jammed it. Okay, we gotta focus. All right, Snowfall. Niggas die. Mm. Niggas die every day, B.
That's the premise.
The Snowfall is like
drugs.
It's a narco show. It covers the part of LA in the late 80s, mid 80s when Reagan was in office as the president and they were using cocaine sales to fund anti-communist guerrillas in South America. Mm-hmm. So they use the black neighborhood to fund money. And they had people that work with them, they had CIA agents and shit like that until it all got blown up in the paper. So it's just the dramatization of that time because there's a person that really lived that life and that it's time. That's Freeway Ricky Ross's story. And it was created by John Singleton, Mr. Boys in the Hood. Mm-hmm. So this is the last season.
Great director, by the way.
Yeah, yeah. And like he was there, like, you know, he passed away. What, probably passed away during COVID? Because he was there for the first two seasons. And then, you know, life happens. And death is part of life. And but Snowfall is great. Last season, it's just like, you know, whew, it's nasty in the streets, man. And, you know, it goes from one thing to another. Life is really about timing. You know, like the timing of what you're born into and what you can do with that time. Because maybe you might be better off early, in a different time era, but this is, you was born here. So now it's like, damn, if I was born in the 70s, I'd have killed. But like, I was born in this time. I hate it here. You know, like, damn. Maybe if I get reincarnated, I get a good time period. You know, I don't know. But that's Snowfall. What's the other one I was watching when you got here? Oh, Power Book 2, Tyreek, Mary J. Mary J plays sad very well. Maybe because that's
she a lot of her best that internal depth of strength.
Like, I believe Mary J is sad about her son dying. I just hear sad songs. Zaya, this is, she finna write off. She finna write a hit. If Mary J really had lost a kid, she had to make a song. Oh, that song finna be so full of, oh, that's finna go triple platinum. Oh, all that pain gonna be in that song. I said, we can't play this with nothing at funeral because this sound is sad.
I mean, she knows how to draw from personal strength of, like, being hurt or losing someone. So, like, she's believable. But, I mean, I still see Mary J when I see her.
I want your lover in your sectoral working every day.
Nah.
I don't know.
I'm thinking of I Can Love You.
Oh, yeah.
But she's still kind of rough but soft at the same time.
Rough and soft at the same
time. Yeah, a nigga want a rough and a soft nigga. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, those are my shows that I watched this week that I enjoy. If anybody want to talk about my shows, please comment, DM me. I'm figuring out a way if you had to call in because I really like to talk about these shows in depth, but I don't do a good job when it's my time. Moving on.
He needs some banter back and forth.
Moving on, you fine folks. I got to give y'all a name. What if I call y'all the biggies, but that's not going to work.
Fine folks is like awesome.
Fine folks. All y'all folks ain't fine. All y'all ain't folks.
It doesn't matter. You know what? It's all about owning it and being confident. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, it's one thing to be big. It's another thing to, like, own it. You know? Like, only when you own it is when you can accept it and when you can move from it.
That leads us into a topic that was sent in by a loyal watcher. Being overweight in school. So for me, no one came for me because they didn't want these problems. And I was cool with everybody. It was some big kids in school that didn't do well. I was like, you gotta pick something different, bro. Cause I can't save you all of the time, my guy. Like, you can't always, sometimes you gotta figure out when to strike and when not to. Like, sometimes you had that shit coming.
So you were saying you was a big kid that got along with everybody.
Yeah, I was a big kid, but I was still in the in crowd. Like, even with someone trying to come for me, they ain't have much to shoot on because I'm big and I'm fly to you. Now what? Like, and I got people that's going to defend me because I'm not good at snapping, but I'm good at getting results. So I make sure I know how to navigate through everything. Mm-hmm. I went to a Mid-County high school that was where I was only a black person in my graduating class, but it wasn't always that sparse. But like, I made it work. I went there from middle school to graduating high school. And I ain't had no problems, for real. I played sports, but that wasn't my shit. I was always in some shit with people that had something to do. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So I was cool. Like, I didn't have no problems. Mm. Yeah, I was good.
I don't know. I was big in school, so, you know.
Where'd you go to high school?
I mean, I'm from Kansas City.
Oh, yeah. We don't know what the fuck going on out there.
Yeah, you don't know. So, yeah, but, I mean, I was always a cut above. So, I never really got along. Not necessarily got along, but I never really shared the same ideology as people my age. Mm-hmm. I always, like, hung out with either older, like, or I always had a different vision or a mindset or a goal. You know, because life was really rough for me, so. You know, I just never really kind of understood what was going on with the people in my era, my generation. You know, people I went to school with. Like, I never really meshed well with them. Mm-hmm. So I always connected with the older population, like older women, older men, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm with that too. I mean, even though most of my friends were my age or a little bit older, no older than maybe a year ahead. Mm-hmm. I still would get the best out of that bunch to be cool with. You know what I'm saying? So, like, yeah, like, some shit, I was like, no, that's not me. But let's see. I would always be like, okay, that ain't really make all the sense in the world. Let's see where this goes. Just for the sake of, like, I already know, like, oh, this ain't it. You know, but, like, you sort of just, oh, okay, like, this is not everything, but let's see where the, I was always, let's see where this goes. Mm-hmm. But once I get to, like, whoa, whoa, whoa. Hmm. Understand, I gotta be home by 1:30. I don't have no other place to go. So if you can't get me back, because I didn't have, like, my mom didn't have a car, so I didn't have a car. So, like, luckily I sort of was able to negotiate with people how to get from the after school shit and being social and getting home, because, like, I can't always stay at your house the next day. Like, I still had, you know, shit to do. Mm-hmm. But I have a car, so, like, you know, if I had to catch the bus home, I would, which was hella whack. But, like, everything was like, I got to negotiate shit because I don't have a camel.
You so damn
sweet. And I need a way to get back and forth.
Mm-hmm.
You know? I had to make myself worth picking up. Mm. And have it valuable to the group.
Mm-hmm. Funny guy. Mr. Smart Guy.
I'm too communal. I'd be trying to build communities. How about the over-sexualization of TV programming?
Oh, my God.
Why? This, okay.
Oh, my God.
Before you share your piece, which is going to be way better than my piece.
No.
Just watching Power, must we have all the relationships between everybody explicit? Like, I didn't need... I'm good with implied sexual actions.
Nigga, it's like the 90s.
I know where to go for action that's the real action.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't need y'all to give me almost like... Is Cinemax even... They even still even show...
No, that's softcore porn.
Because you get that now.
Softcore porn.
You can get that there on P-Valley. I was like, y'all...
I think
I don't need this.
I just really feel that nothing is implied. Everything is just upfront, abreasted, you know, like, this is what I am. Bam, you gonna see me. I think there's nothing left to the imagination because we are just overly gratified and satisfied with the information that we receive now. You know, everything used to be so subtle. You know, it used to be implied nature. You know, you could wear like a crop top denim, you know, outfit. And it's just like, because your body banging, like the mindset would like go to, you know, oh my God, like I wonder what's under there. Or, you know, like even a man with like some jeans, it's like, oh my God, I wonder what's in them jeans. Like everything is now, no, you got to fucking see what it is. Like I got to see what it is before I get it. I got to know what it feels like before I can make a commitment. You know, it's just too much, you know, like there's nothing left to the imagination. And then like we didn't grow up seeing, you know, you had to sneak and fucking find a Playboy or a Playgirl magazine to see some pussy or some dick.
Oh man, she said the big words, guys.
No, I'm being for real. You like, I mean, you had to sneak.
It
wasn't
right.
No internet. It wasn't no shit like that. You had to like see it in the magazines that was wrapped in plastic. You had, the plastic has to be torn for you to be able to get in that motherfucker. You know.
I remember going to the flea market on the.
Just seeing somebody humping, not seeing POV. You get what I'm saying? But just the mere implication that somebody is like enjoying themselves in a sexual manner, like that got you off. No, now we need to fucking see POV, how the thing going to see.
Bust it.
You know what I'm saying? You want to see the motherfucking squirt. Like, it doesn't matter. There's so many fucking genres of what you can see. You know, it desensualizes the intimacy that comes with having that sexual experience. That's what it does. Like, over-sexualization, like, you know, you're never going to be enough for a person that is constantly self-gratifying off of new shit. Like, what happened to, like, normal sex?
Well, technology has shortened everything. Technology...
You can't just do missionary from the back. You know, it's, I mean, always
look
like...
Look at music. Like, look at music. Music songs are no longer, like, 5 minutes, 3 minutes. They're made...
They 2.35, maybe 2 minutes.
They're built for streaming. Streaming came out of the invention of the smartphone.
Yeah, I mean, like, everything, you know, is snapshot. Nothing
TikTok.
Is...
I hate TikTok, but, like... Kids don't have a people. They ain't trying to read the whole book. They trying.
But do you think over sexualization really ties into marriage? Really ties into the sanctity of like actually being monogamous with one person?
I think the falsities of monogamy is causing monogamy to be no longer trusted.
What is because the falsities of monogamy?
That monogamy is a choice. It's not a law. We are monogamy is forced upon us because that's how you build civilizations, how you build societies and cultures out of a predictable structure.
Is monogamy based upon the Christian structure?
Yeah, because I mean, no. Civilization created monogamy for the sake of controlling populations. So that just come of a byproduct of like, how do I make this make sense? How do I control or make things predictable? That's why we have things with labels, because labels make you, I know what this is that goes there. I could bill because I know Jane can come in and do accounting. You're going to do front service so I can experiment, take risk on this part because I have this part labeled and organized. So religion is something to help us make sense of things we can't make sense of.
Yeah, but so what I'm asking you is that do you think monogamy is a bipartisan of Christianity?
Monogamy got here before Christianity.
Or religion. Should I say religion?
No, I mean, monogamy came out of monotheism, which is what Christianity is, but no one that bought into it actually lived it. It's a good idea. Is that a thing? Like most of
the
human
civilization. The women did. I felt like it was forced on the women, yeah, but not on the men.
Because the men had the ability to kill the women. Like,
did they?
The biological advantage of a man allowed men to dominate women. Like, it just.
Did they?
because they just killed their wives and get a new one. Like, there was a lot more women were killed than men, I think, because women were more vulnerable because of men, but then men go to war a lot. So I don't know, like, civilization is built on a hierarchy, like, unfair one, because I think we were better as human beings in a more egalitarian, construction of living as the highest level of where everyone had equal stake in the survival of the group. Which, because you know everybody, because I can know 100 people enough to care, but like once you get to a certain level, like I can't know fuck everybody. Now I can easily move the unknown and see a number. Now you're just a fucking number on the page. So I can't get to know you because it's impossible for me to scale knowing everybody. Because I'm a person, I'm a feels type of way. If like, I'm a fire 150 people I know, or 150 people I just see on the screen. I know these niggas. Fire! You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just what it is. Like, that's the human thing. Like, when you get to such a level of scale, it's easy to make bad decisions or less decisions. If I know, like, damn, I'm finna fire the parents of little Mickey and John. Yada, yada, yada. Like, the human capacities of knowledge is limited. So, like, I make you my enemy. If I make you my enemy, it's easy to fuck them. Hell yeah! They're the Canaanites. The God told me that y'all supposed to move. What about my guy? So yo God, like, look how human. I always find it fascinating how we make God so human in his behavior. I'm like, if God is big as God is, he won't behave like that. He'd be a lot more, I think, a lot more compassionate, I think, but like, all the people that wrote this book, none of you niggas was there. Yeah, I just wrote this shit. It's some sand. 100 years later, I think Jesus did this and God would have, ooh, that shit fire. Right there. Put that out.
I think it's easier to control people when you make it about one person and their decision. It can't be about, like, your individual decision.
You got to make people feel a part of something that they're making an impact on, right, even though they're not.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying.
They're attacking me, but they're really attacking you. So let's, you, if you help me stop them from getting to you, mm-hmm, then like, I was like, oh, that's good. Because mm-hmm, now I'm feeling like they're coming to get you because you protecting me, not knowing that I'm good. But mm-hmm, I want you to believe that by you giving me your money, it's helping me. No, I'm not really. I'm just trying to get you. But I made you feel like this thing is attacking, like, that's just the human thing. Like, you can, in hieroglyphs, yeah, that's not how that war went. But when I get back home, mm-hmm, you chisel this shit in, and mm-hmm, you keep chiseling that bitch. that's humanity. That's mm-hmm, like human civilization. Like, we don't get this far without a lot of good people not being here. That mm-hmm, we'll never know. Like, I would say, like, you will always get
wins. Someone's always a sacrifice.
Yeah, wins you gonna get, wins you don't deserve, and losses you do. And you miss out on losses you deserve. Like, you, it's ass whoopers you should have earned, you didn't get. Mm-hmm. And it's also gonna be some pussy that you didn't earn, you also gonna get. Mm-hmm. You better realize how that works in life before you fuck up. Cause, like, you better be grateful because it's some shit you earned that you ain't get. It's some shit you got that you also did. Oh, I had an extra fry. This motherfucker. Mm-hmm. I didn't deserve these extra. Like, oh, she fucked with. Oh, she mad at him. She gonna fuck me. I know. I didn't do nothing. But I'm gonna go ahead and. You better be grateful, nigga. Because also some bullets that had your name on it that you went home just in time, but you had talked some shit that got you that juice box. Yeah. Sometimes we don't get to it. It's too late.
He said he want
to
make that juice box wet.
That's not. I was just trying to circle the block on that. Damn, Kayvon, what else do I want? What else I want to get off my spirit? I don't know what else.
He wants, you know, he missing that old thing. Cause that's, he wants that old thing back.
Wow, let's not do that.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Once again, comfort.
I just want to make the most of my time here. You know, a lot of time with yourself will make you have a lot of different things.
I think.
Still serving alcohol in here.
You have to know yourself. You have to have time with yourself to understand what it is. What your limitations are.
I'm really testing that now. I'm testing everything I thought I am. So I guess that's also part of, like, am I who I think I am or I am not? you can do all the lab testing you want, but until you go into the field, that's how you know if that motherfucking Teflon on top of bullet or not.
Mm-hmm.
When live fire is real live fire.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so hey, we all get into the age where a lot of people best ain't gonna be here much longer. And you're gonna get a lot of laid to rest.
R.I.P.
Yeah, you just gotta make sure you make the most of yours. Don't let this money worry you. I was happy I never had to, I'm trying to find some shit that if I don't find it, I'm gonna be okay, I think.
You will be.
Okay. You got anything else you want to put in this skillet? I don't have anything. I'm empty.
I'm empty and
thus
I gotta
is
pee.
My soul. All right, y'all. I'm gonna give y'all a better show next time.
This wasn't a bad show. We talked about a lot. What are you talking about?
We did, but I feel I should have done better.
We pre-gamed a little too hard.
We didn't do shit. I'm focused and locked in.
Locked in too. Other than my bladder. What you talking about?
All right. You have any closing thoughts you want to give to the people we haven't named yet?
I think you shouldn't wait for life to happen. I think you should seize every moment. At least try to. Talk yourself into it. You have to be present and in the moment. You know? Honestly. I think that we waste a lot of time thinking of what ifs.
How, Sway?
You just do. You know, I mean, like, whatever situation you in, like, you have to live in that moment, you know, to grow from it, to move from it. Honestly, I think we sit and waste a lot of time thinking that we're going to make a change and, you know. You have to actually be present-minded in the moment. Like, you have to be sporadic. You have to take those chances. You have to live in the moment.
Who to make the change?
Oh, he's going to bring out one.
In my life.
What about you, big fella? Hey, fella. Oh, my God, the breathing.
That was me. Michael would not appreciate the way he spoke to me.
No, he wouldn't. Or the way he was singing.
That too. I'm trying to. I'm
now you're trying to look for the song.
It didn't play as fast as I wanted it to.
Oh my God.
Ooh.
This is his takeaway.
I want you to look at the man in the mirror. Know that man.
Oh, to make a change.
Or one man.
In my life.
He gonna make a change.
He'll change it to a woman now. Like, that's also in the budget.
Oh my God.
Gonna make it right.
All right. That's enough, Michael, before we get banned again. What was your question for me? What'd you say for
what
me?
What is your takeaway?
Man, my takeaways are bad. I don't know, like, just, like, my takeaway from my experience this week, be open, you know? Like, it's okay to be vulnerable. It's absolutely, it's a chance you might get fucked on the risk. You might go.
It's always a chance.
It might hurt. It might, you know, like, it's okay. Like, it makes you better. It sucks to go through it. But, you know, if you learn how to sit in it and take your time with it, it'll make you, you'll feel better on the other end. Mm. There is like the end of the tunnel.
Mm-hmm.
It is. You won't see it, and you'll find all the reasons not to believe it, but it's like there.
Mm-hmm.
All right, y'all. That's what I have for y'all. And I'm going to be able to prepare next week. I hope so.
We will.
Everybody is somebody because somebody else. Love yourself, love each other, and love is all we got.